a new variety of adabu. This particular adabu is known as sarukkal adabu. This particular variety of adabu is known as sarukkal adabu. But in the dance, Bharatanatyam dance world, there is a confusion between sarukkal adabu and sarukkal adabu. They are almost, the pronunciation seems to be the same. Because of that, many of the students as well as the whole Bharatanatyam world confuse the two terms together. One is sarukkal adabu, other one is sarukkal adabu. Sarukkal adabu we have already learned in our practical lesson 7 and practical lesson 8. The confusion has risen because many of the students as well as the whole Bharatanatyam world mentioned the sarukkal adabu as theyya theyyi adabu. There are altogether 4 variations in the sarukkal adabu. We have already learned that. That is like this. Theyya theyyi, theyya theyyi, theyya theyyi, theyya theyyi. This is the category of sarukkal adabu. First one. The second one, because here in the sarukkal adabu we are using the foot position, anchitam foot position, raising the toes up and the whole body is resting on the heels like this. This is anchitam position. But in the sarukkal adabu, that is, we are in a full mandi position. Full mandi position means this is the full mandi position. We are using the full mandi position and doing it. There is a vast difference between the sarukkal adabu and sarukkal adabu. Sarukkal adabu, why this term has been chosen, I felt. Because in Tamil, sarukkal means slippery. Slippery, slipping and all are called sarukkal. This adabu also almost based on that level. Because of that, I hope that most of the people are using this adabu as sarukkal. There are 2 differences between the 2 variety of adabus. One is sarukkal adabu, other one is sarukkal adabu. I thought of doing this adabu at the end when we do the multi variety of adabus at the end. But in our previous 2 lessons, we have learned about mandi adabus. So I thought this would be more appropriate for you to give the explanation about these differences between these 2 adabu categories, and I want to explain this here to you to make you to understand the 2 different terms of 2 variety of adabu categories. The syllable what we had used in our earlier 2 mandi adabus were Tham Vita Tatta Jinna. Both were based on Rupaka Tala. Similarly, the sarukkal adabu which we are going to study today is also based on Rupaka Tala, and the syllable also same. Thaangitta Thattar Dinna for the syllable for this sarukkal adabu தாங்கிட்ட தத்த தின்ன சரக்கல் அடப்பு. We will see what are the hand gestures we are going to use. For the initial level, with the full mandisthana position, we are using the sihara hand gestures. Both the hands, we are holding the sihara hand gesture. And artha chandra, we are using. And also we are using the ala padamam along with the patakam hand gesture. We are using the ala padama hand gesture along with the patakam. And at one point we are using the kataka mukam hand gesture, making the hands to making the Katakamukham hand gesture to face upwards. Then we are using Siharam, we are using Artha Chandra, we are using Alapadumam, we are using Patakam, we are using Katakamukham. For all these hand gestures are being used in this Adam. Now I will explain to you how to do this sarukkal adavu. Step by step I will explain to you. You follow it, then slowly and slowly try to do it in the first speed, second speed and third speed. First of all, I will explain to you how to do this step. This is the sitting position, Mulu Mandisthana position. First, I am going to do the right side. Thaam kitta thatta thinna. 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 Tam kita satta tinna. Tam kita satta tinna. Tam kita satta tinna. This is the right side position. This is the right side. When we do the right side, we are facing the left side. Tam kita satta tinna. See here the Artha Chandra hand gesture I am using. The normal mistake most of the students make, I have observed, instead of Artha Chandra hand gesture, they are trying to do the Patakam. For this step, of course, you have to do the Artha Chandra hand gesture. For this step, when you turn, you have to do the hold. Right side I am using, doing right side this Artha Chandra hand gesture, and the right hand leg. Right hand is in Artha Chandra hand gesture. My body position is in Karuna Mandala Sthana position. Body position I adapted Karuna Mandala Sthana position. Similarly, the third level I am using, when I am using the right side, right hand I am using with the left leg. Right hand I am using along with the left leg. That also Karuna Mandala Sthana position is adapted. Tam kitta tatta thinna. Tam kitta tatta thinna. Tam kitta tatta thinna. Tam kitta tatta thinna. First, for the right side, when the left left leg should be taken back along with right hand. Now I will explain the left side. Left side I will explain to you. This is the Mulu Malli Sthana position. I am doing it. Tham kitta tat tat thinna. 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 I am using the right left hand with right leg. Tham kitta tat tat thinna. Tham kitta tat tat thinna. Here right hand with left leg at this posture. Tham kitta tat tat thinna. This is the left side. How we are going to do the right side? Same way we have to use it for the left side also. For doing the left side, we have to face the right side. Left side doing, while we are using the left side, we are using the right side. First, I will demonstrate you in the first kala. That is enough for you at this grade. First, you have to get used to the step and you must know how to do the step. Then only you can do the second and third speed. There is no hurry to do it in the second and third speed. First of all, you have to learn how to do and how to do it in the first kala. Later we can do it in the second and third kalas. That means the second and third speeds.
Didn't know.